I'm Elias, and I will present you a small demonstration of AVRILOS, which in this example demonstrates in connection of AVR microcontroller and Xilinx FPGA. I have a small board and I have downloaded a design which is presented in this article, which contains an 8-channel RC servo controller, which is controlled by the microcontroller through a 3-wire interface. Okay, let's go now to see the setup. Okay, I will present you now the setup. The whole setup is a small old car that was disassembled and has only a power motor, and I placed a servo for driving the wheels. I have my main board, which the controller and AVR and the FPGA, Xilinx with 5K gates. In this design I have implemented an 8-channel RC servo controller, which is controlled through a 3-wire interface by the microcontroller. I have also a small head that rotates the IR detection sensor, which measures distance. And also for this demo, although it is unmounted, it is a small grip that I will show you as well, working with this RC servo controller. And of course, using the AVRILOS. This is my small board. This is handmade. It was actually an old board that was retrofitted for this example and for this article. Here you can see I have the AVR CPU, the controller, and FPGA and a Spartan XC05 with 5K gates. Also, I have added this small dual motor driver, although I use only the one channel to drive of this small robot the motor. I have left the board connectors unconnected intentionally in order to provide a step-by-step procedure of each connection. This is my ISP, which is a Polulu programmer, put it in a small box, and there, from there we have two cables. The serial port connector has the standard TTL signals of RX, TX and ground, and the port can provide power 5 volts for a possible serial port adapter for a standard serial port. The programming connector is my standard connector, which is not actually the Atmel standard. It's a little bit different to allow easier routing between the connector and the Deep 40 package microcontroller. Now it's time to connect the first servo, which controls the front wheels of my modified car and which will be the base of my robot. Then I will connect the head, which carries the IR distance detector, and again it's a servo, and I will connect this to the servo port on a second channel. My final servo, it's the gripper, and it will be connected to the next available port. Finally, this is the power port, which here I provide the DC to power board. And finally, this is the board working. You can see the LED alive flashing. Here you can see the main loop of AVRILOS, where the application is run after some timer interval. Now we're going to compile the code. We'll type make. We wait for the compilation with the enemy messages, and now we are going to program the board using the Polulu programmer in this example. Okay, ready. Now on the terminal, we enter the serial application mode because we are on the debugger mode, and then we can control the board using the keyboard commands. Okay, I rearrange the camera to see, to be able to see. I press L and the gripper is increasing, and K, the grip is closing. You can notice that the motion is not very smooth. I will rotate the head with the IR sensor on it and left right. Now this is a dead zone, and then the wheels turn. Okay, now let's see the back wheels. This is the back wheels are controlled by the PWM of the microcontroller itself. It's not connected to the FPGA. Okay. Now the LEDs indicate the condition of the control lines of the motor driver, so you can see when I am going forward or backward and stop. Now, in order to make the motion smoother, we need the application to run outside of that timed loop in order to provide more smoothly the commands from the keyboard to the RC servo. In a real automated application, this might not be the case, but for this example, I believe it's a good thing to do, and you can see the full capabilities of this design. Okay, let's compile again. This is another compilation run, and program the device. Okay, I've downloaded, and now we are going to the terminal. Again, we are in a debugger mode, so we enter the serial application, and now we can run the tests. You see now that the motion is smooth. Let's grab something. Okay. It's very funny. You see that the motion is very smooth. Let's see now the wheels of the vehicle. It's much smoother. Thank you for your interest in AVRILOS and this particular article regarding FPGA and AVR microcontrollers. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope you make a good use of it. Thank you.